your class English. I am your teacher Neelam Singh ma'am. Today I am teaching you a very interesting poem, that is The Kite, from your book Honeysuckle. Now in this poem, children, as the topic is very clear to you, the poem is related to kite, and every small child knows what is a kite. Sabko pata hai ki patang kya hoti hai, how does it fly in the sky, and why the children like the kite. So first I will read the lines, then I will explain the lines, so that the poem is very much clear to you. How bright on the blue is a kite when it is new. With a dive and a sip, it snaps its tail, then soars like a ship with only a sail. As over tides of wind it rides, climbs to the crest of a gust and pulls, then seems to rest as wind falls. When string goes slack, you wind it back and run until a new breeze blows and its wing fill, and up it goes. How bright on the blue is a kite when it is new, but a raggeder thing you never will see when it flaps on a string in the top of a tree. Now this is your poem, and I've read the lines of the poem. Now the first six lines I am explaining to you. In the very beginning, the poet says, how bright on the blue. Blue means sky. Neele aasman pe kitni chamakti hai the kite, how it shines in the sky. When it's new, jab nahi hoti hai to neele aasman mein kitna zyada chamakti hai. With a dive and a dip, suddenly the movement. Now here the poet is telling about the movement of the kite. Sometimes its dive comes down and sometimes it dips and comes more down with the help of the wind. It snaps its tail. It takes its tail. It makes a very cracking sound with its tail. और उसके पीछे वो जो पूँछ होती है वो हवा में बहुत आवाज़ करती है. It makes a cracking sound. The tail makes a cracking sound. Then the kite, because the wind is there, then it soars, means goes up into the sky like a ship. When the kite goes up in the sky with the help of the wind, it gives us the appearance as if the ship is sailing, and it starts moving from one corner to the other in the sky. The patang hawa mein lehrati hai. So this movement of the kite is described by the poet and compared by the poet with the ship sailing on the water. So this is your kite, the movement of the kite. As over tides, and when there are high waves of wind, it rides. When the wind is very high, it also rides very fast and climbs to the crest. Or when the wind is very fast, the kite goes very high in the sky with the help of the wind. I mean, goes to the crest means goes to the top of the sky with the help of the wind. Of a gust and pulls. And the stormy wind, gust means the wind which is flowing like very fast like storm, it moves the kite forward. Of a gust and pulls, when the wind is very fast like a storm, it pulls the kite up into the sky. Then suddenly, in the four lines, the kite is flying very high due to the stormy wind, because due to the fast wind, the kite is flying very high and high to the top of the sky. But when suddenly the wind falls, or the speed of the wind decreases, then the kite seems to rest. Then suddenly when the wind becomes slow, आप देखते हो कि जब हवा कम हो जाती है तो पतंग बीच में ही एक जगह पर धीरे धीरे ही मूव करती है, जैसे रेस्ट कर रही है. When string goes, string means the rope, string means the thread by which the kite is tied up, goes slack, it becomes, जब उसका धागा ढीला हो जाता है, slack means to become loose, string means the thread. When the thread of the kite becomes very loose, you try to wind it back. तुम उसे अपनी जो चरखी है उसमें धागे को दोबारा से बांधने लग जाते हो. And run until, and then suddenly the wind starts and the kite starts flying again. and run until a new breeze blows. And when your kite is, when you tie the string up, then you run up to it. तब फिर तुम उस पतंग तक जाते हो and suddenly the new breeze blows. अचानक धीरे धीरे हवा चलने लगती है and the wings of the kite start filling. जैसे ही हवा चलती है पतंग के जो पंख हैं वो फिर हवा से भर जाते हैं and up it goes. And with the help of that wind which has started blowing now, the kite again starts movement in the sky. Again the poet says, and he is describing the beauty of the kite. How bright on the blue. अब नीले आसमान में चमकती हुई काइट कितनी सुंदर लगती है when it is new. When the new kite flows in the sky, flies in the sky, it looks very beautiful. But a rough thing happens. Suddenly something very bad happens, something very rough and torn happens. That is, ragged means something very rough. So suddenly a very rough thing happens, you never will see, which you never see earlier. Suddenly it happens, a very bad scene happens suddenly, which is never not seen by you earlier. What is that scene? What is that rough thing which the poet is mentioning here? वो जो rough चीज़ है या जो फटेहाल चीज़ है वो क्या दिखाई देती है उस पर पोएट को? When it flaps on a string, जब वो फड़फड़ाती है on a string, जब वो अपने धागे के साथ कहीं पर अटक जाती है और फिर पेड़ के ऊपर, जब when the thread of the kite is stuck in the branches of the tree, then the kite flutters for some time in the sky and then it is for and then it is for all and then it remains there for ever. And you cannot, you try your best to take out your thread out of those branches of the tree. You try your best to take the kite and the thread out of the tree, but जब वो पेड़ों में अटक जाती है then the kite does not come out of that branches of the tree and you lose your kite. So this is the bad thing. जब आपकी पतंग किसी पेड़ में धागे के साथ फटके अटक के फट जाती है then you don't like this. तुम्हें ये अच्छा नहीं लगता है. So the thing, the ragged thing which the poet is referring here is when your kite is torn due to being stuck in the tree, in the branches of the tree, when the thread of the kite stucks in the branches of the tree and it is torn, then you feel very bad because every child loves the kite and wants to fly it, but when it is torn because it has got stuck in the branches of the tree, then you don't like it. So this is your poem, The Kite, written by, the poet is Harry Benn. Harry Benn has written this poem, The Kite. So I hope, children, this poem is clear to you now. Now the question answers I will be giving to you after some time. So first listen to this video carefully, try to understand the poem, and I am giving you some words of which you have to write the I am telling you to underline the words of which you have to write the opposites. First is bright, you have to write the opposite of bright. New, and then there is a word rest, you have to write the opposite of rest. Pull, slack, opposite of slack, what is it? Back, what is the opposite of back? And then there is a word that is top, what is the opposite of top? You have to write never, what is the opposite of never? So these are some words, you should underline these words and try to write the opposites of these words in your copies. So I hope, children, you like the poem. Thank you very much.